17 got over. Start now. 16 or 17?
No.
In order to sort arranged elements, use one of the built-in method collections.sort. Sort method is a static method in the collections class. Supply the ArrayList. Whatever elements are there, all the elements are getting sorted. You will be getting sorted container, sorted output. Collections.sort. Copy the same program. We are importing comparator. You will be knowing more about comparator later. From the java.util package, ArrayList collections comparator. Three members we are importing. Comparator from the java.util package. Collections dot reverse order. In order to sort in the reverse order, get a reverse ordered comparator. Comparator which is for sorting in the reverse order. Which is for sorting in the reverse order. Comparator which is for sorting in the reverse order. Sort method, it's a overloaded method. In the previous program, we have seen sort method which takes only one argument. There are two sort methods. The second sort method taking two arguments. First one is the ArrayList. Second one is comparator type. Here comparator type is a reverse ordered comparator type. Whenever you are using second sort method, it will check what is the comparator type. Comparator type is a reverse ordered comparator type. So sorting will be happening in the reverse order. Sorting will be happening in the reverse order. You can just compile and run. You will be getting reverse ordered sorting. We are simply following the process whatever is required. We are not developing a logic. Whatever is required for sorting, whatever is required for reverse ordered sorting, we are not developing a logic. We are using the methods which are already developed. We want to know the process. Only finding out the process. You can compile and run. Come to the next one. You will be getting class cast exception. Compilation is very proper. While running, you are getting a class cast exception. Class cast exception. So here, three objects are double class objects. One is an integer object. First one is a double number. It is boxing into double object. The double object is upcasting to object type. Second one is an int number. It is boxing into integer object, upcasting to object type. Again, double object, upcasting to object type. Again, double object, upcasting to object type. While considering original objects, three are one type. One is another type. Three double objects, one is an int object. Three are the double objects, one is a integer object. While sorting, the first and foremost condition to be followed is all objects should be same type. If you want to sort, every object should be same type. First and foremost condition in order to achieve for sorting, all elements should be same type. If all are person objects, you can sort it. If all are buffalo objects, you can sort it. If some are person objects, some are buffalo objects, you cannot sort. Sorting, comparison. How you can compare one person with another buffalo? If all are person objects, we can able to compare and we can do the sorting order. If all are buffalo objects, we can able to compare and we can identify the order. Likewise, if all are integer objects, you can compare and you can identify the order. If all are double objects, you can compare, you can identify the order. Wherever you are looking for a sorting, container should contain same type of elements. If elements are same type, then only we can do the sorting. Otherwise, you will be getting class cast exception. It is trying to compare double object with integer object. While comparing double object with integer object trying to convert into double. It cannot be done. You will be getting a class cast exception. The first and foremost condition to be followed while looking for sorting is container should have same type of elements. While covering wrapper classes, I clearly told every wrapper class is a subclass of comparable interface. Every wrapper class is a subclass to comparable interface. Because of this, sorting is possible. So here, all four objects are wrapper class objects only, But three are one type of wrapper, one is other type of wrapper. You are getting a class cast exception. Come to the 20. So we are not using arrays class here. You can remove this import. All are string type. Even though under double quotes 1, 2, 3 is there, that is also a string. Any number which is specified under double quotes, it is considered as a string. Any number inside a double quote, considered as a string. Because of all our string type, sorting will be very success while sorting. Internally, it is making use of ASCII code. internally making use of ASCII code. First digits, then uppercase, then lowercase. Based on the ASCII code value, it is finding the sorting order. If you are not considering the case, then first five are having same content. Case is variable. Based on the ASCII code value, it is finding out the order. Come to the next one. Class A, 1 attribute, 1 constructor, we are adding 4 elements, string type, integer type, 2 elements are A type objects. Inside a string class, toString method got overrided. In every wrapper class, toString method got overrided. In class A, we didn't override toString method. Inside a string class, toString method got overrided. In every wrapper class, toString method got overrided. Whereas in the class A, two string method not overrided. While printing array list, it is calling two string method on every element. Inside a string, two string method overrided, we are getting ABC. Inside an integer object, two string method got overrided, we are getting 90. In case of class A object, two string method is calling. It is object class two string method, we didn't override, we are getting class name @ hexadecimal representation memory address. Even for fourth element also we will be getting class name @ hexadecimal representation of memory address. Now you can understand importance of overriding object class to string method. Copy the same program. Inside a B class, two string method got overriding. Inside a B class, object class, two string method got overriding. Thank you. While printing array list, internally toString method is calling. It is calling toString method on every element. Now all the elements are B objects. Inside a B class, toString method got override. It is printing the content, browsing the content. State of the object, I is equal to 9, comma, I is equal to 4, comma, I is equal to 5, comma, I is equal to 2. In the previous program, class A, object class toString method is not overrided because of the you are getting an address. But in the current program, B class object class toString method got overrided because of that. We are getting state of the object. State of the object is nothing but object content, attribute values. Compilation and running both are very success. We are getting state of the every B object whichever stored in the array list. Copy the same program. Define 23.
Thank you.
The online students, somebody not muted your client, mute everybody. Is happening here. We added C objects to our list. Inside a C class, two string method got override. Object class, two string method got override. while printing this list, you will be getting every object's content. Whereas, while calling sort method, you will be getting class cast exception. Even though every object is same type, that is C type, still why we are getting class cast exception? Please observe. All the objects are same type. All are C type. Even though every object is C type, why we are getting class cast exception? We are using collections sort method. It is having one contract, one condition to be followed. We have to follow one contract in order to use sort method. We have to follow one condition. That condition is every element should be a type of comparable. Every element should be a type of comparable. Every element should be a type of comparable. All wrapper classes already implementing comparable. String class also already implemented comparable. That is why we were able to sort wrapper objects, string objects. Now we are trying to sort C objects, C class objects. But C class not implemented comparable interface. Comparable. Sort method developed by collection API developers, they provided one contract, one condition. If you follow that condition, then only sorting will be very successful. Every element should be a type of comparable. Our C class is not a type of comparable. That is why we are getting class cast exception. String class already implemented comparable interface. Every wrapper class already implemented comparable interface. Likewise, whatever classes we are developing for collections purpose, all the classes should implement comparable interface. Here C class not implemented comparable interface. That is why we are getting class cast exception. Copy the same program. Thank you. This is sorting successfully. Sorting very successfully. The reason is D-class is a type of parable. Whatever contract is required, same we have followed. It's a type of comparable, almost similar to string class and wrapper classes. Every wrapper class implementing comparable interface. Similarly, D class also implementing comparable interface. Comparable interface available in the java.dot langpad. Inside a java.dot lang package, comparable interface available. Comparable interface, it is a functional interface. Comparable interface, it is a functional interface. Comparable interface, it is a functional interface. It is contained only one method. The interfaces which are having only one method called as a functional interface. Comparable interface containing only one method. If any interface containing only one method, then it is called as a comparable, sorry, then it is called as functional interface. comparable is one of the functional interface. It is containing only one method, that method is compare to. Compare to method. It is taking object type as an argument. Inside a compare to method, you need to find out the difference between two objects, one attribute value. Here, this dot I minus argument dot I. This dot I minus argument dot I. Two objects, I values, we are comparing. Two objects, I values, we are comparing. By using sort method, ArrayList is containing, multiple elements of D. What this sort method is doing is taking first element, calling compare to method, supplying a second element, finding out whether first element is bigger than second element or second element is bigger than first element. Blindly it is calling compare to method on D object. Compare to method on D object. Please observe. Sort method, it cannot take a decision based on which attribute it has to do the sorting. Why? Because class D is our own class. We only developed a D class. How sort method will come to know based on which attribute it has to compare multiple D objects? We had to explain based on which attribute value sorting should be done. In one class, there might be n number of attributes. Based on which attribute value? Based on which attribute value, it has to compare one object with another object. That is why, looking for compare to method from us, we are the developers of D class. Inside a D class, we only provided all the attributes. Based on which attribute, we are looking for sorting. Same attribute should be specified in the body of the compare to method. This is very important. Sort method calling compare to method. Sort method calling compare to method on D objects. Calling compare to on first D object, supplying a second D object as an argument. Based on the return value, it is identifying which one is a bigger one. Assume, first one is a bigger one, then swapping first one with the second one. Then on second one, again calling compare to by supplying a third one. Assume, second one is a bigger than third one. Swapping second one with third one, then calling compare to on third one, supplying the fourth one. Internally, almost like a bubble sort mechanism. Based on which attribute, sort method has to take a decision which attribute is bigger. For that purpose, internally looking for compare to method. This is very, very important. Comparable interface containing compare2 method. In the body of the compare2 method, try to find out differences between two objects, a particular attribute. This dot I minus argument dot I. Compare two method returning one integer number, that is the difference between this dot I minus argument dot I. Let us observe, compare two method is calling on these two elements. On first element calling compare two, supplying a second element as an argument. In the body of the compare two method is nothing but first element. Argument is nothing but second element. This dot I is a 9. Argument dot I is a 0. 9 minus 0, positive number. If it is a positive number, first element is bigger than second element. Swapping is happening. Second element keeping in the first place, first element keeping in the second place. Now in the second place, new d of 9. On that new d of 9, comparative method is calling by supplying a third element. 9 minus 8, again it is a 1. So second element is bigger than third element. Swapping is happening between second and third. Likewise, it is continuing. If there is no compare to method, you will be getting class cast exception. Collection API, only two major things. Please observe, entire collection API, only two things. One is sorting, second one avoiding duplicates. While covering object class, we have seen equals method and hash code method to avoid the duplicates. For sorting purpose, we are using comparable interface. There is one more interface, comparator, that you will come to know in down the line. Comparable interface. It is containing compare to method. It's only one method. It's a functional interface. Now compilation and running, both are very success. Copy the same program. Develop 25. E class containing two attributes. E is a subclass to comparable. Every object of E containing two attributes. Based on which attributes sorting should be done? Based on which attribute sorting should be done? That you have to explain in the compare to method. It can be I or it can be J. It can be I or it can be J. Based on which attribute you are trying to sort? We are implementing compare to method by considering second attribute J. Even though the attributes are there, even though two attributes are there, we considered only one attribute. We have considered J. All the objects are E type inside a E class. Compare to method override it based on J value. Now sorting will happen based on J value. Please check it out. Second output. In the second output, based on J value, something happened. First element will be 1 comma 0. Second element will be 8 comma 1. Third element will be 9 comma 5. Fourth element 0 comma 8. Last element 3 comma 9. Sorting is happening based on J value. If you wanted sorting based on I value, go to the compare to method, modify I minus argument I. Can compile and run. Now you can check it out. Second output, you will be getting 0 comma 8, 1 comma 0, 3 comma 9, 8 comma 1, 9 comma 5. Comparable interface, it is suitable only for classes which are containing one attribute or only one attribute as a decision maker, even though multiple attributes are there. Inside a string class, only one attribute, you are trying to store only one value. In the string object, only one value, not multiple value. In the wrapper objects also, only one value. If any object containing only one value, then go for comparable. In the previous program, D class containing only one attribute, comparable, it was very suitable. Current program, E class containing two attributes, comparable, not suitable. There might be requirements like, in some scenario, sorting based on I. In some other scenarios, sorting based on J. That cannot be possible here. In entire execution, sorting either based on I or based on J. Not both. Assume in one project, in some requirement, sorting based on I. In the same project, in other requirements, sorting based on J. That cannot be done. You had to achieve sorting based on only one attribute. Comparable interface introduced for achieving sorting based on one attribute. Single attribute classes. Single attribute classes uses comparable sorting, like a D class, like a string class, like a pre-wrapper class. In one wrapper object, we cannot store multiple values at any time, only one value. In one string object, we cannot store multiple string objects. We can store only one string content. String class, all wrapper classes, and the D class, class D, suitable with variable. E class, person class, book class, any class which contains more than one attribute, then comparable should not be used. While using comparable, only one attribute, based on one attribute, based on one attribute, we can achieve the sorting. Class containing multiple attributes, if at all, sorting is based on one attribute only, in all the requirements, then only go for comparable. Assume person class. Person class attributes first name, last name, age, email. In one requirement, you need to sort multiple person objects based on first name. In some other requirement, all person objects you have to sort based on last name. In some other requirement, all person objects you have to sort based on age. Comparable interface cannot be used in this type of scenarios. If class containing one attribute, decision maker is only one attribute, then only go for comparable. If multiple attributes are there, then we have to go for comparator. Copy the same class. Comparator, it is there in the java.ut package. Comparator, it is available in the java.ut package you have to import, it is also functional interface. It is containing only one method. Now F class not required to implement comparator. We are not deciding only I for sorting or only J for sorting. We are not taking a decision based on which attribute sorting should be done. F class doesn't have any sorting. We are not specifying any kind of sorting in the F class. F class carry two attributes. Both are getting initialized through constructor. Both are browsing by overriding the string method. Now let us see what could be the development for sorting. Define a separate class similar to G class, develop another class. G class, H class, both are implementing comparator.
are getting three outputs. First one is A without sorting. Second one, sorting based on I value. Third one, sorting based on J value. In the same program, in one requirement, we are sorting every F object based on I value. In another, in the same program, in another requirement, sorting every F object based on J value. This is very important. Please observe, G and H both are comparator type. G and H both are comparator type. G class and H class both are implementing comparator interface. Comparator interface, it's a functional interface. It is containing only one method. That method is bar. Method name compare. Compare method taking two arguments, both are object type. Both we are downcasting into F type. Then getting a difference from both objects based on I value. Compare method also, and type is int. It is returning int type. G class implementing comparator interface. From the comparator, whatever method inheriting, that is compare. Compare method implemented. Very similar to G, H class implements comparator. Compare method, two arguments, both are downcasting to F type. Inside F objects, taking the differences based on J value. Now, while calling sort method, we are using second sort method, second argument, comparator type, G object, comparator type. What sort method is doing is taking two elements from the array list. Both elements sending to compare method of G object, finding out which one is bigger. If first one is a bigger, swapping. Then taking second and third elements, supplying to compare method of G object. Inside a G object, compare method is a, that is developed by us. Inside that compare method, we have taken a decision of how to compare. Based on which attribute comparison should be. Based on I attribute, based on I value, sorting should be done. Inside a G object, compare method, taking two arguments, both are downcasting into F type. From F objects, I value. Based on I value, identifying which F object is bigger. In the previous case, we were using comparable interface. It was containing compare to method. It was comparing current object with argument object. In the current program,
F is not a comparable type. F is not a even compare. F is not a comparator type. Comparable type. F class doesn't have any kind of sorting mechanism. Separately, G class, H class. Inside a G class, we implemented compare method. In the compare method, downcasting both arguments into F, then using I attribute based on I value. Inside a G class, I based on I, sorting is happening. In the H class, based on J, sorting is happening. Please observe, while executing this selected statement, what this second sort method, which is taking two arguments, second sort method, what it is doing is taking two elements from the array list, sending both elements to the compare method of G object. If G object returning positive value, first object is bigger than second one, swapping is happening. Then taking second element and third element, supplying both to the compare method of G object. If compare method returning a positive number, then second element bigger than third, swapping is happening. Then taking third element, fourth element, supplying to the compare method. If compare method returning negative value, then third element smaller than fourth element, swapping is not required. Then fourth and fifth sending to compare method. If compare method returning positive number, fourth element is bigger than fifth element. Likewise, it is continuing. While going for list dot new of H, sorting will be happening based on compare method from the H class. Inside a H class, compare method developed based on J value. It is taking two elements from the array list. Both are sending to compare method of H object. If compare method returning positive number, first element is bigger than second element, swapping should happen. Swapping is happening. Then taking second and third element, again calling compare method on H object. For all positive number, second one is bigger than third one, again swapping. So here, sort method doesn't know based on which attribute sorting should happen. That you have to explain either through comparable or through comparator. Comparable most suitable for single attribute class. Comparator most suitable for multiple attribute classes. For one attribute, develop one subclass to comparator. Assume person class, first name, last name, age, salary. For first name purpose, develop one subclass to comparator. For last name purpose, develop one subclass to comparator. for age purpose. Develop a subclass to comparator. For salary purpose, develop one subclass to comparator. Widely using is comparator. If at all, single attribute class, go for comparable. Multiple attributes, definitely you have to go for comparator. In the collections class, there are two sort methods. First is sort method, taking only one argument, that is array list. That array list should contain every element comparable type. Second sort method, taking two arguments. First argument, array list, which contains any type of elements. Second argument should be comparator type. Second argument should be comparator. While calling second sort method, which is taking two arguments, ArrayList can contain F objects which are not implementing either comparable or comparator. Second sort method, ArrayList, elements can be without comparable, without comparator. But second argument should be comparator type. You have to supply an object to comparator. While using first sort method, that is sort method which takes one argument. First sort method. Sort method which takes one argument. What are the conditions to be followed? Two conditions. First condition, all elements should be same type. Second condition, elements should be comparable type. While calling first sort method. Sort method which is taking one argument. If you are using first sort method, which is taking one argument, two conditions you have to follow. There is one more condition that you will come to know later. As of now, we have seen two conditions. First condition, all should be same type of elements, single type of elements, one type of elements. Second condition, that elements should be comparable type. Comparable type. Two conditions you have to follow. When using second sort method, second sort, which is taking two arguments. First one is ArrayList, second one is comparator. First one is ArrayList, second one is comparator. What are the conditions to be followed? Here, ArrayList should have same type of element. No need of comparable or comparator for the elements. All the elements should be one type. That's all. ArrayList elements doesn't require to be either comparable or comparator. ArrayList elements, all elements should be one type. All elements are F type. All elements are F type. F is not implementing comparable. F is not implementing comparator. Come on. The second condition is, second argument should be a comparator type. Comparator type. Comparator. Inside that comparator, compare method should evaluate elements which are available inside RLS. This is the condition. Please observe. Inside a G class, compare method should compare elements of RLS type. RLS type, elements of RLS type. What are the elements? F type elements. Inside a G class, compare method should compare only F objects. Inside a H class also, compare method should compare F type elements. The second condition, very important. Second argument should be comparator. Inside that comparator, whatever compare method you have implemented in the body of the compare method, you have to compare elements of type RLS. First argument is RLS. Elements are F type. Inside a G class, compare method, it has to compare F type only. Inside a H class, in the compare method, you have to compare F type only. Let us consider RLS containing D objects. RLS containing D objects. G class compare method, it is comparing F objects. You will be getting class cast exception. RLS containing D objects, G class compare method, it is comparing F objects. RLS containing D objects, 2D objects sending to compare method of G object. Inside a compare method, it is downcasting to F, but RLS containing D objects. D objects cannot be downcasted into F type. You will be getting class cast exception. The second condition, very important. Inside a RLS, whatever type of elements are there, inside a RLS, whatever type of elements, if RLS containing D type elements, then in the compare method, you have to compare only D type. If RLS containing F type elements, in the compare method, you have to compare only F type. Let us consider RLS containing multiple person objects. You supply one comparator where it is comparing buffalo objects. Person object trying to convert into buffalo. You will be getting class cast exception. If RLS containing person objects, then comparators compare method should compare only persons. If RLS containing buffalo objects, then comparators compare method should compare buffaloes only. Understood that? In throughout collection API, we will be keep using comparable and comparator. Comparable usage is very less, single attribute. Most of the times, we will be using comparator. So here, separate G class, H class. Instead of separate G class and H class, why can't we go for anonymous inner class? We already went through anonymous inner class. Very easily, while calling sort method, first argument RLS, second argument anonymous inner class, which is implementing comparable in the body of the implement the compare method. Inline development rather than separate G class, separate H class. But in most of the places, before JDK 1.8, using anonymous inner classes for comparator purpose. But from JDK 1.8 onwards, lambda expressions. I'll cover the lambda expressions. So in the collection API itself, first we will see anonymous inner classes usage for the comparator purpose. Afterwards, I'll show you lambda expressions. Instead of separate G class, while calling sarc method for the second argument, you can go for new comparator of, define anonymous inner class. In the body of that, define compare method. The complete process I'll show you in the next class. So today, whatever content covered, very important, please try to practice again and again. Understand the clear difference between comparable and comparator, and also why do we require these comparable and comparator. We'll continue the same tomorrow. Enjoy karo. All the very best.